made easy. Life tells about the Constitution. Well, you've seen the commercial where a great big brick of cheese drops from the sky and it lands in one little cracker and puts all the flavor in the cracker. This is the cracker. Everything that we're saying today, everything every speaker has spoken about, everything that you hear on talk radio these days talks about the United States Constitution and the very central importance it plays in our liberties. So I want to say a few words about the Constitution, and we're going to turn it right back over to these other great speakers. I'm kind of a teacher of the Constitution, so I brought a pop quiz. And I'm going to ask you a few questions, but I've got good news. Part one is very easy. I'll even give you the first answer. What is the great binding legal agreement that was drafted by our founders and signed in Philadelphia 222 years ago today? The United States Constitution. What is the great document that guarantees our liberties and our freedoms?
The United States Constitution.
What is the great document that gives our government powers and carefully prescribes and limits those powers?
The United States Constitution.
You guys get 100% of the pop quiz. Now we're going to go to part two. The Constitution has seven main articles and a certain number of amendments. How many? Uh-oh, we're in trouble. The first, a couple of good answers. The First Amendment guarantees five freedoms. Name them.
Press, religion,
petition. We're having a little more trouble on those. Now, here's my point, folks. Our government is bound by the chains of the Constitution, and that has been the founders' own words. We know from history that if they will not be bound by the chains of a binding legal agreement that they take a solemn oath to uphold, that they will take those chains off and slip them onto us.
Oh, no.
If we are to keep them in their proper role, and if we are to enjoy our freedoms, then we must know this book. Here's a question I don't want you to answer out loud. How many times have you read it since high school?
Four or five.
If you had to answer that question, most of you would be embarrassed. Now, obviously, I sell books. The book is designed to make the Constitution easy to read. All of the original Constitution is on the left-hand page, and an easy reading version on the right-hand page, just like Shakespeare made easy. But you don't have to read this version. Go online, US.gov. Go to Heritage and get a 50-cent copy. You can read it online for free, but you must read the Constitution. Otherwise, you will not really be able to have the courage of your own convictions. You'll have to have the courage of Glenn Beck's conviction or the courage of some other person's conviction. You can read the whole Constitution in under 30 minutes. Take 30 minutes. Read the whole Constitution. You'll get your mind around it, and you'll know whether the Constitution says that the government can pay cash for plunkers. Now, I am going to give a little tribute to the dissenters, and I hope they'll give me a big shout-out for this one. I believe that good quality health care is a human right.
Yeah!
The government's power! The only way that we're going to know these things is to read the Constitution. I trust that you will. And if you have trouble with some of the terms, the letters of mark and reprisal, with some of those difficult terms, then please consider going to theconstitutionladies.com or see me over at the booth. Thank you, and God bless America.
Yeah!
Here in Colorado, the state faces several hundred billion dollars in quote deficit. I see it as an opportunity. Some people see it as a crisis. But imagine if you were, however, in California. $300 million deficit would be a celebration given the nearly $30 billion deficit they're in. One of the reasons Colorado is in such better financial shape is our taxpayers' Bill of Rights.
Yeah! Thank you, Doug!
All right!